Good morning, class. Welcome to the online classes for physics of class 10. In the previous classes, you may have seen that we have seen the electric current chapter, in that we have seen what the electric current is, that is the rate of the flow of the charges per unit time, which was given by Q by T. So Q was a charge and its unit was coulomb. And if you talk about the current, it is noted by the letter I, and its unit was coulomb per second, which was given as ampere. And we have seen that to move these charges means, as we provide some external source, the charges can move, and this movement of charges used to conduct electricity. So movement of charges will give you current. So to move the charges, there is some external source should be provided so that the charge can move from their place. That is what the electric potential was, that as we provide an electric potential, the electron present at anywhere, they can move out from their place, and the required point they can come. So this movement of charges will provide an electric current, and that potential will be given by V. That is, a V means it can be given as voltage or an electric potential. So to relate this electric potential and the current, that is V, is directly proportional to I. Means as you increase the potential, the number of the charges movement will be increasing. So as you provide a potential and as you increase the potential, the current will also increase along with it. So V will be directly proportional to I. And we know that the potential and current will be measured by a device which were named as voltmeter and the ammeter. And remember this, that whenever you connect a circuit, the ammeter should always be connected in series, and whereas the voltmeter should always be connected in parallel. That means series means we know that we will be connected it to by end to the end, like left should be connected to the right, others right should be connected to others left. So this should be end to end connections. And as you talk about the parallel conditions, then it should be side by side connection should be there. That means it should be one handed right to right and one handed left to left. So that's what the connections of the ammeter and the voltmeter were. And after that, Lord Simon Ohm, the person scientist who gave you a relation between the voltage and the current, and the law was named as Ohm's law. That is the relation between the voltage and the current, that is V is directly proportional to I. And that proportional, as we remove that proportional, we will get a equal sign, that is proportionality constant R. So you will get V is equals to I R, and from there R was the proportionality constant named as the resistance, and the resistance value was V by I. And we know that the unit for that resistance was given by ohms, and we know that sign also. So here we are going to learn about the resistor itself, that how can it can be connected and how it is used. So this is what the diagram for the resistors. Here you can see these resistors have some colorful lines on it. This one known as the bands. So these bands will tell us that how much resistance will be provided to the electric circuit. Now this is not there in your syllabus, but just see what the colors tell you. So you know that in every, here you can see that in every image of the resistor there are some color bands, first three, and the last one, it is a colorful band. Color band is there, that is maybe golden or it can be silver also in some resistor. So that is what the tolerance means, how it can tolerate the current through passing through it. So this tolerance will be more for that of the gold and less for that of the silver. That means 10% tolerance will be there for the golden line and 5% tolerance will be there for the silver line. And this color bands will be have a specific number, that with that number we can just give what is the resistance that this resistor will provide to that one electric circuit. So this is what the resistors are. Every boys may know that, because they used to go to the shops for that working arts and all. In that you may have seen that these are used, and if you want to see a chips also in some motherboard chips and also are there, and that if you open also you will get different kinds of devices, and that one will be the resistor. And this is what a symbol for the resistor, it is given as a resistor. And we know that we can connect the resistors in the two conditions, one will be series, another one will be parallel condition. If we talk about the series condition, it is something like if we connect it end to end, means we can connect these resistors from one resistor's left side to that of the other's right side, and again that the left side of the other resistor will be added to the right side of the third resistor. So that is what the connection in the series. So resistors are connected in series like this, as you can see here. And here you can see that what are the instruments or the device which are used. Here you can say this is the cell or a battery, since cell is only a single one, and here the lots of cells or the combinations of cell are used. So this is what a battery is. So this is what battery, and you know that the longest terminal was named as a positive one, this long terminal is given as plus and the short terminal is given as minus. So this is a battery. And if you talk about a V, this is what voltmeter is, because it is symbol for the voltmeter. This is what the ammeter, that is symbol for the ammeter. This is key. And I have told you that key is something like a box and it will have the hole. If you just keep the pin, means this key into inside it, if you pin it, that means the current can flow through it. And if you take it out, this pin from that hole, that means the current cannot flow into that circuit. So this is what the key is, on and off, you can say. Switch on, off, and we used to say at our homes, but this is what key is. And we know that the current can flow through this circuit. So we here you can see that between the resistances, voltmeter is connected parallelly to it. And if you talk about the ammeter, it is connected in the series conditions. Okay. So this is what the connection of the resistors in the series. So now we will see what the parallel condition of the resistance is. Similarly, here you can see that the connections of the resistors parallelly. This is again a battery. A key, but here see that the voltmeter is connected parallel to that of the resistors, and again ammeter is connected to series. But we can see that the every end of the resistors are connected together. But there we have seen that one end of the resistor is connected to the other end of the second resistor, and the second resistor's end was connected to that of the third resistor's end. But here we can see they are connected by the side, means all the left sides of the resistors are connected to the single voltmeter's terminal. And if we talk about the other ends of the three resistors, are connected to the negative terminal or the positive terminal of the voltmeter. So that is what the voltmeter should always be connected in parallel. And if we talk about the ammeter, should be connected in the series condition. So one thing we have to see in both the diagrams, that as you provide the voltage also, or as you provide the current to this, we know that in the series condition, the voltmeters are connected to the end in the parallel condition. So the potential is divided in the series condition, and in the parallel condition, the current used to get divided in the different resistors. And we know that in the home appliances, we need current in different rooms, right? Different appliances we use, and their current usage is also different. Like if you use an iron, it uses more consumption, and if you talk about a TV, it have less consumption. For mixer grinders, they have less consumption. If you talk about a geyser, it have more consumption. ACs. So these are the different appliances are needed, and the current should be divided in the different appliances in different conditions. But our home used to get a 220 volts from the transformers which we have in every street. So the volt which is coming to our home should be same. So we know that it should be not divided, but the current should get divided. So which condition is there that the voltmeter means by providing the potential will be same, but the current will get divided? Here we have seen that the current will be the same for all the resistors. This current will same for all the resistors, but the potential get divided. But here what it is, that the potential applied to three resistors will be same, but the current will get divided. So by dividing the current, we will be more useful, because it will be useful for appliances also, that different current will be used for different devices, and the potential will be same for that of the every device. Because like at home, we get on the meters like a single potential and throughout the home, but what is the use of the current, it depends on the appliances. So it is more useful in condition of the parallel. And as we add in resistances together, if you talk about the equivalent or the total resistance of these three resistors together, then it will give the more resistance, means the equivalent resistance will be more than that of the single resistance. And if you talk about parallel, then it will be less than that of a single resistance, means the equivalent resistance will be less than that of a single resistance. So we'll see how this happened, because the formula for the series and the parallel are something like that. They can give a mathematical treatment, and on solving it, we can get the value of the resistance. That means the total resistance will be more than that of a single resistance. Like here, for series, it is like R is equals to R1 plus R2 plus R3. If you have N resistors, means if you have 5 resistors, it will be till 5. If you have 4 resistors, it will be till 4. If you have 2 resistors, then it will be R1 plus R2 itself. So that is the sum up of the resistors. And if you talk about the multiple resistors in parallel, we know that 1 by R1, 1 by R2, 1 by R3, if you have N resistors, it will be till Rn, and if it is 5 resistors, then it will be till R5, if it is till 3, then it will be R3, and if it is only 2 resistors, then 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2, and mathematically you can solve the questions. So 2 resistors in parallel, we can see 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2, together the LCM will also come R1, R2 in the bottom, and in the numerator we will get R1 plus R2. But here it is given reciprocal of that 1 by R also, because in left side it is 1 by R total, and we doesn't require 1 by R, but we need R total. So when we take the R total on the top, the reciprocal will be done in the fraction, that is R1 plus R2 will go to the denominator and R1, R2 will go to the numerator. So this was the resistors equivalence. Now only what we have seen, these diagrams are showing you that how the series and the parallel connections are there for the resistances. So we know that if same exactly currents in the resistances in the series condition, but exactly the same potential will be across all the resistors in the parallel condition, because the current divides in parallel and the potential will divide in the series condition. So this is what the difference is. We know that the connection here, firstly you see the connection for the series combination, they are connected end to end. If you talk about the potential difference, then the potential difference get divided in the series condition. So in questions, if it is asked that calculate the potential of the 1 ohm resistor or calculate the potential of the 2 ohm resistor, that means the potential is divided. So you have to again use that Ohm's law for the single resistor. But if it is taken as an equivalent resistance, then you can add by R is equals to R1 plus R2. So by using this Ohm's law, we will be using different formulas for the different resistors so that we can get the potential through equal and each resistors, because the potential is getting divided in the series condition. And we know that the current throughout the circuit will be the same. So if you take out a single current by the Ohm's law, then for every resistor the current will be same. But for voltage or a potential, we have to take out the Ohm's law for a single every resistors continuously, right? And if we talk about the parallel conditions, so then in the parallel condition they will be connected in side to side conditions, and the potential across all the resistors will be same. Like if you provide a 10 volts battery, that means for the all the resistors the voltage will be 10 itself. And if you talk about a current, it will get divided. Like for resistance first, it will be of different current. For resistance second, it will be different current. And if you take different multiple resistors, it will be of different values of the current. So you have to use different Ohm's law for every resistors. If you know that V is equals to IR, and we know that the potential will be same for all the resistors. Now I consider that a resistor is used which is of 5 ohm and the potential is given of 10 volt battery. So we know that the potential will be same for all the resistors. So V will be 5 only, but R, it was given as a, sorry, V was 10 and R was 5. But I, we have to take out for the resistor. But in series it is different, that the potential, it will get divided. So we cannot use that 10 volts battery, but resistor will be used, but the current is same. So if you take out the current for a single resistor, then it will be same for all the resistors. Okay, but we know that when they are together added, the total resistance of the series condition is more than that of a single resistor. And if you talk about the parallel condition, the total equivalent resistance will be less than that of a single resistor. So it is more useful, and the resistance should be very less, then only the current can be more, because they both are inversely proportional, because it is the opposing nature of the current. So as you increase the resistance, the current will decrease. So resistance should be less in our home so that we can get a durable current and a heavy current so that we can use in our appliances. Got it? So when two resistors are connected in parallel, we know that different currents will be flow through the different resistors, because the current used to get divided, but the potential will be same throughout the circuit. That means potential does not get divided. And in series, we know that the potential gets divided, but the current will remain the same. Okay. Now see this example, that calculate the equivalent resistance for the circuit which is connected to a 24 volt battery. Here you can see the figure that it is connected to a 24 volt battery, and the two resistors are given for you, that the two resistors are connected in series. Even in exam the circuit diagram would not be given, but if it is given that the two series resistors are connected in series condition, or the two resistors are connected in parallel condition, you just have to draw. So remember that there are different ways to draw, but what the series condition should be like, they should be connected end to end and to a single volt potential. Like it will be connected to one end will be connected to negative and the other end should be connected to positive. But in parallel, both of them will be connected to, means if you are using three, then the three of them will be connected to a single terminal. Okay, so the connection show you should draw. By the question itself, you should be able to draw that connection. So it is written that calculate the equivalent resistance for the circuit which is connected to 24 volt battery, and also find the potential difference across 4 ohm and 6 ohm resistors. So we know that a potential difference, it is connected in series, so what will be divided? V will get divided and I will be the same. So it is given that 24 volt battery is already going to the bits, you are providing 24 potential to that of the circuits, and there are two resistors, that is 4 ohm and 6 ohm. So what is the equivalent resistance throughout the circuit? We know that the series condition, so resistance will be R is equals to R1 plus R2. So 4 ohm plus 6 ohm, we will get 10 ohm. So the total equivalent resistance will be 10 ohm. Now, if you talk about the current throughout the circuit, because in the throughout circuit, the resistance is 10 ohm. Now, only we have taken out the equivalent resistance or the total resistance in the circuit is 10. So, the total resistances are given, then the total current should also be taken out. And total circuit is given the potential of 24 volt itself. We know that both the resistor will get different potentials, but current will be same. So by using Ohm's law, V is equals to IR. V is already given that total circuit have 24 volt, right? And total circuit have 10 ohm resistance. And what will be the total circuit's current? It will be V is equals to IR. And not dividing it V by R, we will get I, that is 24, the total potential, and 10, that is the total resistance. On dividing it, we will get 22.4 ampere, that is current. And now what we have to take out, that is the potential difference across 4 ohms and 6 ohms, means since the potential is getting divided, so we have to take out that how much potential this 4 ohm resistor will get and how much potential this 6 ohm resistor will get. So 4 ohm resistor, how much it will get? We know that V is equals to IR. V is already given, but 24 volt, but it get divided, so we have to take out the V. And I, it will be the same which we have find out now, that is 2.4 ampere. It will be the same here itself for both the resistors. Throughout the circuit, it will be the same. So for I, we will be using 2.4. And for R, for the first resistance, it will be 4. For the second resistance, it will be 6. So first one, we can write it as 2.4 into 4. It will be 96. But point is there, so it will be 9.6 volts. And if you talk about the V2, that is the potential across the second resistor, then the I into R2. So I will be 2.4, the similar for both the resistors. And if we talk about the second potential or second resistor, then it is 6 ohm. So 2.4 into 6, we know that it is 144. So decimal will be from one digit, so it will be 14.4 volts. Now, see the second example, that is calculate the equivalent resistance in the circuit and also find the current in the circuits. So the current is getting divided in the panel, we know. So we should take out the current throughout the different resistors. But firstly, we should know that what is the current throughout the circuit and what is the potential throughout the circuit. And we are providing here 24 volts potential. So resistance should also be taken out for the whole resistance in the circuit. So total resistance is given for the panel as 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2. So it will be 1 by 4 plus 1 by 6. On taking the LCM 4 and 6, we know that it will get 12. So it will be 3 plus 2 and it will be 5 by 12. It is 1 by R. So we have to reciprocal it again, because sometimes we doesn't used to get reciprocal of it. We used to forget. But remember that it is the value for the 1 by R and we need only R. So it R will become 12 by 5. On dividing it, what it will be? It will be 2.4 something. Again 2.4 volt came. So now the resistances will have the potential across every means it is same everywhere in the for the resistors, but the current will get divided. So now for the resistance first, what will be the current? So we know that V is equals to I R, and I will be equals to V upon R. For first resistor, it will be I1 is equals to V upon R1, because the current is divided for the first and the second differently. So for the first one, it will be I1 is equals to V by R1. So V by R1 means 24 volts battery is used, because V is same for all the, so it will be 24. And the first resistor, it is given as 6 ohm, so it will be 24 upon 4. First resistance is given as 4 ohm, so it will be 24 upon 4, which will be 6. And if you talk about the second resistor, it will be 24 upon 6, that is given as 4 ampere. So current will be that, like a different resistor will have a different current. So the, it is also given that I, for the total circuit also we have to find. I1 and I2, we know that it got 6 ohm and 4 ohm. So what is the total current flowing through the circuit? It will be I1 plus I2. So total current will be same, that is I1 plus I2. It will be 3 resistors, then it will be I1 plus I2 plus I3. For multiple resistance, we can take it as N. So it will be 6 ampere plus 4 ampere, which is, we know that it is a 10 ampere current throughout the circuit. So this is what the resistances connections and how they get parallel and the series connection. So remember that the parallel connection is more useful than that of the series connection. If we have series connection, then if it one get defect, then we know that the total circuit can get defected. And if it is parallel, then we can manage that if it one it get defect, then the others can get the potential as similar, because the current is getting divided. So potential is same, so the potential is provided to every resistor. But for different resistors, we get different current also. So if one get defect, the other resistors can get the equal currents in that. Okay. So this is what the different resistors and what is the values for the current and the potential. So thank you, class. In next class, we will be seeing the further topics.